The term sensory processing and integration refers to the mechanisms of how we feel. How we feel the world around us and how we feel ourselves in the world. How we generate a map of our bodies and a concept of ourselves in space and in time. It describes how our nervous system, our whole brain and body work together to produce responses to the world, produce a plan for action or movement, self-preservation or self-care, or what is often referred to as behavior. Understanding the transformative power of sensory processing for health and wellness is critical if we want to thrive and not merely survive. Everyone processes sensory information, and from conception through the lifespan, sensory processing and integration impacts every domain of human function and participation. Sensory processing and integration supports our ability to form relationships, take care of our bodies, learn about ourselves, and develop a sense of identity. It also supports our ability to develop a sense of other people in the world and is a foundation for understanding that people are diverse and different. Sensory processing keeps us alive and safe, away from what our brain and body might perceive as threatening or toxic. Sensory processing and integration also underlies fine motor skill development, gross motor skill, speech and communication, and academic success. It has a profound impact on functional emotional development. Think of a domain of human function, and sensory integration supports that process. Of course, sensory processing has the potential to derail or disrupt human development, and it can cause or contribute to a multitude of challenges. Sensory processing is how our brains and nervous systems use what we sense to make sense of the world. If it's not working for us, the world feels disorganized, threatening, unpleasant, and unsafe. When sensory processing goes wrong, it can contribute to developmental delays, challenging behaviors, difficulties with social participation and attention. Disordered sensory processing can prevent us from ever feeling calm or safe. It can result in anxiety, disorganization, difficulties with coordination, and reduced participation. This is where an occupational therapist or allied health professional with advanced training in sensory integration therapy can make a tremendous difference. But just as important as understanding the impact of disordered sensory processing is the need to understand that sensory processing and integration is integral to the human experience. Every living thing processes sensation. Even plants have a sort of vestibular system. Everyone processes sensory information differently, and many sensory processing differences do not need to be disabling. With increased understanding, environmental tweaks and accommodations, we could see increasingly diverse communities of people coming together with improved productivity and participation. Sensory processing refers to the mechanisms of how you feel and how that guides your actions. Spreading awareness about the 8 sensory systems and incorporating principles for sensory health and wellness into everyday life will not just benefit the 16% of people who are identifiably struggling with sensory processing challenges. Every child in every classroom will benefit. Every teacher, every allied health, mental health, and helping professional will benefit, as will the people they are helping. 100% of adults in the workplace, high school students, and patients on hospital wards will benefit from an improved understanding of sensory processing and integration. We believe this will reduce the behavior crisis in our schools, support better mental health and psychological well-being, improve infant mental health outcomes, challenge stigma, and enable people to achieve their full potential. So thank you for joining the conversation, and we hope to continue conversing with you about it as we all learn more about this important domain of human function.